fearsome creature ever to haunt the oceans. Today, this formation is commonly known as Sharktooth Hill.
15 million years ago, this place was a shallow marine sea, maybe 100 to 200 feet deep, full of all kinds of life, particularly vertebrate life. Sharks, marine mammals and fish, birds overhead. It would have been a lot like the Chesapeake Bay is today, but with much, much larger types of prey and predator. It would have been truly an amazing sight to see.
Megalodon, literally translated, means big tooth. And these 7-inch teeth are almost all that remain of this extraordinary creature. No skeletons have ever been found. What we do know is that Megalodon ruled the seas for some 25 million years, going extinct just under 2 million years ago. What they looked like, how big they were, how they lived, how they died, is a mystery science is only beginning to crack.
Megalodon was probably the apex predator of all time. People think T-Rex or something like that. It's dwarfed by Megalodon. Megalodon's huge, maybe even 70 feet long. T-Rex wouldn't have a chance against this thing. T-Rex's head would fit in this guy's mouth.
But how big was that mouth? How large a bite could it take? Unlike the T-Rex, which left many bones behind, the skeleton of a Megalodon, like all sharks, was made of cartilage, and cartilage rarely fossilizes. All we have left of this enormous predator are a few saucer-sized vertebrae and teeth, but these teeth might be enough. By starting with just one, it might be possible to reverse engineer a nightmare we call . The ocean's most lethal hunter was Dunkleosteus. It belonged to a group of armored predators called placoderms, or platy-skinned fish, that ranged in size from the 30-foot, 4-ton Dunkleosteus to tiny fish no larger than several inches. The placoderms hunted the global seas during the Devonian period, but none rivaled Dunkleosteus.
Probably the biggest, baddest fish that lived at the end of the Devonian era. It's one of the top predators that's ever swum in the oceans of the Earth since life evolved several billion years ago.
Despite its power and killer whale size, Dunkleosteus's legacy has proven to be fragile. Unlike their Devonian competitors, descendants of the armored placoderms don't exist today. Our clues about Dunkleosteus come from the only physical evidence that survives, fossilized dermal armor that covered the front end of the fish. Armor that, after death, would have dragged Dunkleosteus to the bottom towards preservation. Once the bone settles to the bottom, a protective layer of sediment must cover it in order to fossilize.
In the vast majority of cases, this doesn't happen and the animal just decays away, just like roadkill you might see along a highway.
Fossilization is actually a very rare thing to happen to any given specimen, bone or a shell or a leaf. 99.9% of everything that's ever lived doesn't fossilize, and we don't have it in the fossil record.
If the bone is covered by sediment, then water flowing through the pore spaces of the bone can precipitate minerals out in the little crevices in the bone. Those minerals then turn into a representation of the bone, and all the original organic material decays away.
Fossils of Dunkleosteus's armor plating reveal a beautiful bone structure that made this animal into a model predator.
The top of the head is almost like a drawbridge. There are two hinges on either side of the skull, and there's actually this large soft tissue opening right here. When Dunkleosteus had seen a predator or seen a prey item in front of it and wanted to attack it, it would drop its lower jaws down. But this thing would lift the top of the skull up like a drawbridge.
Based on their study of fossils, scientists restored the musculature to a computer model of Dunkleosteus's skull. They were able to determine that the creature's four jaw joints worked in concert to open and close with force and speed.
The length of time it would take to go from a closed mouth to an open gap was less than a 50th of a second. You'd have a big suction formed by the sudden opening, and anything that was swimming in front of it would actually get drawn back towards the mouth. And as soon as these shearing jaws come together, you've got that animal cut in half. Dunkleosteus has a bite force roughly equivalent to Tyrannosaurus rex, which has absolutely the largest bite force that we've ever measured for any vertebrate animal.
This would also rival an alligator's bite, which is the strongest of any living animal. Amazingly, despite how lethal Dunkleosteus was, this placoderm was technically toothless.
Thank you. you to want what I want you to feel. But it's like no matter what I do, I can't convince you to just believe this is real.